Good morning, everybody, or at least it's morning for me here in sunny Portland, Oregon. I'm Nate Angel. You may know me as Helodl on Twitter. I apologize to anyone who speaks Nahuatl because I'm probably not pronouncing that correctly. I'm here to talk a little bit about Open Learning Experience Bingo, which was a collaborative project that I was involved in, and just give you a brief sketch about it. So I'd like to start out first by saying, why is it bingo, right? So a group of us got together and designed what ended up being a game to enable folks to have discussions about the different ways that educational experiences, like assignments, activities, or classes, could be open. And we were thinking about ways that they could be open that went beyond sort of very narrow definitions of open, like really good things like whether or not the materials might be openly licensed, to really expand our thinking about what open could be. And I'd like to gesture back toward the deck of cards that I think it was Andre was presenting, because I think there's some real commonalities between this and the project that he was describing with the deck of cards at the Fab Lab. So just to give you a basic sketch of how it works, there's a bingo card, right, in the classic bingo way. And that card is made up of squares that represent the different kinds of ingredients that a learning experience can have in it. And so we tried to kind of catalog the different kinds of ingredients that a learning experience might have, like materials, activities, skills, tools, people, places, times, et cetera. And so you can see the basic bingo card has squares for each one of those ingredients. And you'll notice how the square is sort of open and leaking off the edges, and there are empty squares that can be filled in it. And the idea here is that the bingo card itself is open and can be expanded or modified in its use. And so you'll see that kind of idea going throughout. And so if we look kind of at the ingredients more specifically, you can see the kind of definitions that each one has. And sure, there are probably other ingredients that you can imagine that a learning experience might have, and that's why there's these open squares, so you can add them in. I'm not going to go into detail about all these because we have such a short time today. So just to kind of give an example of how this might work in practice, you can imagine sort of playing bingo with this experience that we're going through today, where we're all learning from each other in these Creative Commons Lightning Talks. And so, just looking at the different presentations that have come to us today, we might say, well, the materials are open. We got a check mark there because, like my slides here that have a Creative Commons license on them, a lot of the materials that people have been sharing are open in a sense, right? So check. And then people might get checked because there's a lot of openness in the participation of different people. Like a call went out really widely to the whole world that anyone could participate in this activity. And we're all here today from all sorts of different points of views and walks of life and countries and positions. Same thing with places, right? I'm in Portland, Oregon. You're probably in somewhere else. You're somewhere else, I'm guessing. So it's very open and inclusive in the sense of incorporating a lot of different places. Time, well, we have this really scheduled time for the live lightning talks that we're experiencing right now, but they're being recorded, and so people will be able to enjoy them asynchronously as well. The goals, like we all have different goals. There's an openness to the kinds of goals that we have, both as listeners and as presenters here. And then in the design too, I would like to give special credit to Creative Commons for really this whole lightning talk idea came out of kind of a community-based thinking about what would be a good idea, and the community got involved in the design. So the actual design of the experience we're having today was sort of open. So you can see how you can sort of start to check things off. And then maybe there are things that aren't checked off, like maybe some of the tool, like we don't have a lot of flexibility in the tools that we're using in this learning experience. So that, we might say that that one is not as open as it could be. But that's not a bad thing, right? We're just trying to kind of think about and catalog what's open here. So there's another whole dimension, if you will, to how one might think about the openness of any learning experience, right? And so in addition to the ingredients that one finds in these boxes on the bingo card, there's also the idea of sort of different ways that things can be made open, different dimensions of openness. And so again, here's another list. We don't have a lot of time to go into it here, so I'm not going to go through it all. But everything in this presentation is linked to much more in-depth descriptions of what's going on here. And so you can see that if we looked at one of the ingredients of a learning experience, and someone might want to mute because I'm hearing some background noise. You can imagine, like, if we just look at materials, like the materials of a learning experience, right? We can ask ourselves if that ingredient is sort of being opened along all these different dimensions, and then we could move to tools and ask, are the tools being opened with all across all these different dimensions and so forth? And so we go from the kind of simple bingo card out to a much more complex multi-dimensional bingo card, right? Where every ingredient box has multiple dimensions of openness that it can be that can be thought about and it can be measured on. And so like let's just think about a couple of examples of this so that we can kind of see how it might actually happen in action, right? So I kind of applied this bingoing process to a couple of very specific learning activities, and kind of started to color in some things as I went through the learning experiences and kind of thought about the ways that they were open. And you can see that it kind of generates a sort of heat map of the openness of a learning experience. And so you can see the one on the left, there was a lot of openness on multi dimensions around the materials for that learning experience. But then if we look at the one on the right, we can see that it actually had a much more sort of spread out openness, in the sense that there was a lot of openness in reflecting about the different kinds of ingredients that were in the learning experience. And there was a lot of connections outward from those ingredients to other elements in the world, or other kinds of materials, activity, skills, tools, people, et cetera. But there wasn't, for instance, a lot of like surfacing or sharing of those learning materials built into the learning experience itself. And so if we think about what bingoing would be like in the real world, what would you use something like this for? And so I've thrown out a few examples here of how one might apply open learning experience bingo to some real cases, like a student or a teacher or a program might use it as a way of sort of thinking about the openness of an experience. Or you can probably imagine your own examples as well. I'd just like to recognize that there were a lot of people involved in bringing this together. It started out as a rubric where we were thinking about kind of like measuring the openness of things, and then we realized that that itself was a closed process. And so we expanded it out to where it could be a sort of more open kind of evaluation process that didn't involve kind of trying to come up with a numerical score. I would invite everybody who's witnessed this or who is interested to contribute back to the project. You could either fork it off and take it and use it in your own work. It's all the materials for it are completely openly licensed for your use. And then we would also love it if people had thoughts or ideas and wanted to contribute back to the core. If you want to reach me, the links are in my presentation. Be tweeting that out, and I guess we'll probably share the slides with the recording when we do it. So you have that as well. And that's my presentation today, and I'm happy to answer any questions that anybody might have.